molecular and cellular biologists, with blood microscopists, with weapons development experts, frontline activists and researchers, and all the stories I'm hearing from these experts and pundits leads to the same thing. 5G is almost certainly the end game. It is an extinction event brought into our homes, into our classrooms, onto the high street, into the very cells and DNA in our human bodies. It is such a perilous threat that it is almost impossible to imagine, let alone describe. When the 5G signature goes live, it will tap into a multitude of satellites which are in GeoSat orbit around the surface of the Earth. Millions of surface antennas will pick up that signaling and will then scatter the signaling into hundreds and hundreds of millions of different micro antenna systems set up on street lamps and even in your home, which you're not aware of, incidentally. The LED light bulbs in your home invariably contain the micro or nanotech lens flare capacitors, which will receive the 5G signaling, and it will proliferate the 5G signaling everywhere by exploding the signal into billions of photons, which will target everything all at the same time. This is stealth technology. This is invisible science. But what it means in simple terms is that you will be flagged up, visible, trackable inside your own home. Anywhere you move on the surface of the earth, they will have a lock and load tracking capability over you. You will be visible to invisible masters, each one of us, all the time. Today, our governments and the corporate sector have managed somehow to infiltrate the mainframe of our civilization and are pushing through a $20 trillion infrastructural rollout without any, and I mean without any, health science running behind it. There have been no tests. Your government and your health authorities are either in collusion on this matter of genocide and ecocide, or they're just damned stupid. And I would suggest it is the latter. Shame on the technologists and the electricians who are furthering this technology in our homes, in our offices, in our streets. Shame on the legislators and the parliamentarians and the troglodytes and bureaucrats that proliferate our society today. Shame on that echelon for putting their signatures to contracts which allow the fast tracking of this technology into our homes and onto our high streets. Shame on the parliamentarians and international leadership whose wet ink signatures and seals of office are sanctioning and permissioning the rollout of something which is arguably the greatest threat to humankind. Shame on each one of us who now fail to get up out of our homes, walk out of our front doors, and challenge every so-called authority who dares to violate our bodies, our homes, and our future generations.